this is the starting point for our hike. You see on the map here that I made. The map will be listed in the comments. You can get the link and print off the map. We're at number one, and this is the starting point today for our hike. The first 2 miles is the old North Country Trail. Then we'll be heading on the new section of North Country Trail. Finally up to the new section of trail. The trail takes a right here, and everything from now on is new. The trail going behind me, that used to be the old North Country Trail, that goes into a spot called the Ox Bowl. It's kind of a dead end, but people like hiking down into the Ox Bowl. It's there where the river makes a big sweeping peninsula. But we're heading this way on the new section of trail. I'll grab the camera and we'll take a little look at it. That's going to the Oxbow right there, and the North Country Trail is headed this way. Back there where we turned off the old trail and started up the new trail, that was number four on the map. This here spot is number five on the map, and it is allegedly an overlook, but the overlook seems to have grown in. It's not much of an overlook anymore. Tman, I'm at one of the cooler spots on the trail. This is an overlook of the Bad River right here. So it's a really nice overlook. You can see the Bad River down below. But I'll let you guys see it. Here, I grabbed the camera, and here it is. Right there, the Bad River down below there. We're at the top of the hill here, right above the ravine, right down there. I can hear the little brook babbling down there. This is a cool spot on the new section of North Country Trail. I'm gonna grab the camera, and we're going to head down and take a look at the ravine. Here we go. It's a fairly steep trail right here. And there was one spot where they had to put in stairs because the... Here it is, because the trail washed away. I believe this is the spot where they had to put in stairs. You can see there's been some erosion right in here. And so here we go. Here's the one stairway that they recently put in. And gonna continue down and look at the little creek on the bottom, which is really cool. I can hear it right down there. So that's the stairway they put in. And I think this is another stairway they must have put in. Wow, look at that. Gotta be careful here. So I'm gonna land at the bottom of this thing if I don't watch out. It's a little dicey. Taking my time. And like I said, here's the other stairway that wasn't here the last time I was here. Little Mankey's crew did a great job here getting this ready for the grand opening. Okay, then we have, at the bottom, we have some rock steps here. There's the little creek there. And I'm just being slow because I don't want to fall head first. So cute little creek here that we have. And I believe looks like the bridge is good. Looks like they put some chains on it though, some cables, just to make sure it won't go away in the future. And beautiful bridge. There's the creek. There's the creek going down that way, right there. And 2015 Roving Trail Crew. This is new here too. The steps right here, that's brand new. I think this is where the trail went before, right over in there. And you can see it's pretty much gone. So he built this stairway up here. This is fantastic. They've done a lot of work since the June floods. And here we go. So that's the that's the bridge. We're hiking at number 8 in the map, and number 8 in the map is kind of a long section of trail that kind of goes along the edge of the hill here. You can look down, going down that way is a swift hill. You can just barely hear the river down there. I think it goes for a long ways. But you're just on top of this kind of like hill at the edge of the valley here. Here in the upper part, right before the northern point, the trail comes on and off these forest roads here. Here's a forest road up here. So it's nice and mowed now. You can see where you're going. If it isn't mowed that great, you can't really tell where the trail's going that much. You got the blaze there. But you just gotta really watch it that you keep following the trail up here and not get sidetracked and go down the forest road. I'm at what we call the northern point. There is an overlook of the Bad River. You can see the Bad River down there. And it looks like the overlook might be filling in a little bit. We gotta do something about that. But this is the place where the North Country Trail turns and starts heading east. All right, we are at the Pipeline Creek Bridge. That's what we call it, the Heritage Chapter. It's basically the North Country Trail comes on this little forest road here. And then it comes down here, and a very beautiful bridge over this creek. And the reason why we call this the Pipeline Creek is because the pipeline's down that way just a little bit. So it's very, very close to the pipeline. There was a beaver dam. Oh, there is the remains of a beaver dam right there. So this has been raining. So this is a little bit higher than it usually is right here. But I've seen it higher than this with the beaver dam. It looks like the beaver dam got blown out down there. But anyway, you come up this way, and beautiful bridge here done by the roving crew. And just take a look here. We're going to show you a little bit about the bridge. The bridge has got what they call cribs right there. And over on the other side, it's a crib. And it's basically this kind of structure that's filled with rocks. And that's what it's like the foundation for the bridge. And they fill it with rocks and stuff like that. So that's one, the main type of bridge that they've been building, the roving crew. But coming up here, like I said, this used to be an old forest road. And so we used that for a little bit. And then we are going to the right up here. And then in just a short ways, I guess I'll hike you all the way to the pipeline so you can see what the pipeline looks like. Oh, we turn here. Again, you gotta watch yourself so you don't go straight. We gotta turn. But we got a pretty good marker there. And then coming down this way, it's just a little bit further, and we're to the pipeline. Right here. Here's the pipeline. Right here. Now they usually come through and mow this every once in a while. But I don't know. See, it says pipeline over here. Right there. But they usually mow it every 3 years or so. And there's the little creek down there that we had the bridge over. We are out here on the North Country Trail, and we're right next to this beaver pond here. Just for a little point of information, there's actually a series of beaver ponds. There's the one dam right in here, and then there's a dam down this way a little bit. There's a whole series of beaver dams here next to the trail. And just a little point of information, those dams are not there, or those ponds are not there when we started building the North Country Trail. So over the course of the last 3 years, they built these dams and have these beaver ponds. And you can see the beaver lodges right there, and another one across the way there. Okay, we've been traveling on this little ridge, which is number 10 on the map. We've been traveling for quite a ways on it ever since those beaver ponds. And right down here is the creek right there. You can see, and that's the same creek that had the beaver ponds on it a while back. But we're just traveling. We're getting to the point where we're going to go away from the edge of the hill here. I'm on a bridge over a drainage. The reason it's called a drainage is because sometimes it has water, but it's not really a creek. If it's raining or what, or in the spring with the melting of snow, it'll have water, and other times it doesn't. So I'm going to grab the camera and we'll take a look at the bridge here. Again, this is come over here, kind of get a side view. It's got a couple, some posts that are the load-bearing posts there. And this was done in 2013 by the roving crew there. So we've been working, this trail's been we're just having the grand opening of it, but we've been working on it for several years. So here it is. There's the drainage right there. Like I said, sometimes it doesn't have water. And we have another drainage down this way, another couple hundred yards. Okay, we're at our second drainage here. Again, this is just a little area that doesn't have water all the time. But now, since it rained recently, it does have water. And we got a bridge over it, much like the first one. So we're making some progress. Okay, we're at a little boardwalk here. And I call this the geographic marker boardwalk because it has you coming along here, and right there, there's a geographic marker right there that is next to the boardwalk. I think they may have done this intentionally. I've seen it done some other places where the trail goes near geographical markers. But then we're gonna head east again. And this is the part of the North Country Trail that we're leaving the state park and we're going on the private land. So please stay on the trail and no camping, no campfire, stuff like that. Be respectful of the private land, or we're not gonna have any place to have a trail. So here we go. Hey, it's Tman. I'm on a bridge. And this one is not for drainage. There's actually a real creek here. Let's go take a look at it with the camera. Right there, it's not too flowing right now, but it is a water source in case somebody needs water. So I just wanted to show that in the video. Now we keep going up this way, and then there's a pile of wood here that's been left over from some projects. I suppose at some point we're gonna have to come out and nab this wood and use it for some other projects. But we've had several huge projects here, which I'm about ready to show you. Here's one smaller boardwalk here. But then up here is the 400-foot boardwalk that the roving crew built in 2013. So there's the placard for it. And they were here building it. So again, we've been working on this. The Heritage Chapter's been working on this, and the roving crew's been working on building structures and stuff like that. It's been a long haul here. And we're coming down the 400-foot boardwalk, which, to give it some perspective, it's longer than a football field. Football field would be 300 feet. This is 400 feet. So this is probably the same size as a football field with the end zones. Now you can see here, we got kind of the woods here, but there's water right down there. There's water all over here. So that's why we have the boardwalk. It's kind of a wet woods here that we're traveling through. And it just was needed. As I remember when we first started working on this section, it was just a muddy mess getting through here. But we have this beautiful boardwalk here, and it keeps going and going and going here. And then we finally will be getting out on Peter's driveway up here. We're coming up to it now. Coming to the end of the boardwalk. And it's just a great project that the Roman crew did for us. We appreciate that. And we come out here to Peter's driveway right here. And the trail takes a little bit of a ride. Just wanted to mention, on Peter's driveway, there's no trespassing on the driveway here. And that you diagonally go over here and the North Country Trail starts up again right here and goes into the woods right there. This is the end. This is the Peter's driveway right here. This would be the end of the, what you call the Copper Falls project right there. That would be coming out there. That's the final segment. And this is the segment between Peter's driveway and Stricker Road.